What's going on, guys? Wingspan here, and welcome back to another video. And today I'm going to show you how to hide your chest in Minecraft Pocket Edition. So if you guys are excited for that, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you're new. And without further ado, let's get right into it. Today I'm actually gonna be showing you 5 different ways to actually hide your chest in Minecraft Pocket Edition, with and without redstone, of course. Don't worry, the redstone part is really simple and I think you guys are going to like it. But this video is great for you in case you want to hide some stuff from your friends and you just want to keep like valuables and stuff away so they can take them. You came to the right place, and as you can see, the first one involves lava. If you're using like lava to decorate your walls or tunnels or anything like that, you can see if we click over here, there is nothing going to happen. Again, same thing. But if we click through the middle one, you can see we're gonna get the chest inventory and we can pretty much hide whatever we want. This chest is right behind the lava, and no, it's not going to burn even though the fire spread is on. As you can see, it's a really simple way to actually hide your chest and it doesn't use any redstone at all. This next one uses a little bit of redstone, but don't worry, it's nothing complicated. I try to keep it as simple as it can possibly be, but as you can see, there is no levers or buttons visible anywhere. But if you actually go to this little corner and press right there, you can see this block is gonna get pulled backwards, allowing us to actually access this chest right here. Again, you can hide whatever you want in this, keep some valuable stuff right there, but when you want to, of course, make sure that it's not visible, you just press again right there, and as you can see, you get yourself another flash wall, and no one will be able to guess that there is any kind of secrets behind there. The way that we did this is really simple. We just have 2 stairs on this side over here. One is going normally and another one is curved, which makes this little block over here, which is transparent, and that means that we can click right through it. And from the other side, it just looks like a flush wall, but if you actually click through this little block, you can see that we have a lever attached to a block and a piece of redstone over here that's connected to the sticky piston, and that's pretty much all there is for the redstone for this one. This next one uses no redstone at all, but it's using the same principle that we have right there with the stairs. You can see if you actually aim right here and press, we're gonna get access to the chest, and this is an amazing way to actually hide your stuff without using any of the redstone and just using some stairs. It looks absolutely amazing. There is no evidence that there is anything behind it. And as you can see, again, uses the same little principle. We just have a normal stair and one that's curved. Again, we get that little transparent block over here and we can pretty much access the chest right over there. But if you're kind of struggling with this, you can maybe use the rail and minecart with the chest for the start. Because right now you're gonna get an indicator that you're aiming correctly. You can see when you aim over here, it's gonna get a little message that says open right there, and you can kind of practice with this. And I prefer to use chest because if your friends know that you're keeping a secret and want to figure it out, they're not gonna get this little message. So just use the minecart with the chest to kind of practice over here, and afterwards you can replace it with the actual chest. The fourth one is definitely my favorite design. It uses a little bit more redstone, but of course the most simple one would be the third one that I showed you. Just using 2 stairs and a chest, you get yourself a 100% hidden chest that you can access at any point that you want. But this one is absolutely great, and I think it would work best in some form of a kitchen. This is not the greatest, I know, it's just for a show. And no, the input is not in the pressure plate, it's just supposed to represent a cutting board. But again, we're using the same principle with the stairs over there to make this transparent block right here. If we press in the corner right over here, you can see that our furnace is gonna get replaced with the chest that we can of course access and put any stuff over there or just take anything that we want. Again, if you want to get the furnace back, we just press in the same little corner right over here, and you can see that our furnace is gonna come back over here, and it's just a really, really simple and small block swapper that you can make. And this is pretty much the heart of the machine. You can see it's really tiny and it works absolutely amazing, and we're gonna show you how to make it block by block right now. So the blocks we're going to need for this are 3 redstone dust, 3 redstone repeaters, 2 redstone torches, 1 button, 1 sticky piston, 2 normal pistons, some block of your choice, and 2 blocks that you want to swap between. go ahead and start off by grabbing the block of your choice and place it just like so, and have a button over here. Then go ahead, place the redstone dust going from the back side, and put a sticky piston facing upwards just like so. Then go ahead, grab yourself the repeaters and place two going in either side, and click them both one time over here. Then go ahead, have that going into a block and on the other side as well. Place the redstone dust on top of them and grab yourself the redstone torches and put them on this side right over here. Then go ahead and finish off with the redstone repeater going into the sticky piston without any delay right there. Then go ahead and place yourself the normal piston on top of this torch going in this piston right over here. Then go ahead and make sure that you place the block that you want to swap first, just like so, over here. In our case, it's going to be the chest, and place another piston just going into that right over here. And have a block that you're going to swap right over here on top of the sticky piston. And as you can see, once we press it, it's going to swap it with the chest. If you press it again, it's gonna swap it for the stone brick right there. And last but not least, if you have another design that doesn't use any redstone at all, this is great if you are living in a house and have this as some kind of the closet. Excuse me, Kyle, you have to move a little bit, thank you. And if you actually open this door, you can see we have few chests right over here that we can store any stuff in. And you may be wondering, well, this is not really that hidden, you can see there is no hidden stuff over here. But if you actually go inside our little closet and close the door, we get ourselves a really nice hidden chest right behind the door, and you can pretty much store your valuables over here, because once the door is open, there is no way that anyone can tell there is a chest right over there, and you can pretty much maybe store some dirt or some useless stuff over here, so once people actually open the door and take a look at the chest, they will just think it's some kind of the junk chest or something like that. And even if they go inside of the room and inspect it, they're not gonna see anything unless they close the door, which is really unlikely. And that's the last design. So that's gonna do it for today's video. If you guys have enjoyed it or find any of these designs useful, make sure to drop a like down below and subscribe if you're new. Of course, if you think any of your friends would enjoy this type of content, make sure to share with them. But as always, I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.